completely. Hebrews, the 7th chapter and the 25th verse. John B. Gough, the world's greatest temperance lecturer, was given a text by his godly mother, which indeed became like buried treasure, for it lay hidden within his heart for 7 long years of dissipation. It was, "He is also able to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him." His sins rose mountain high before him. They seemed indelible. The past could not be undone. But he met Jesus Christ and found that his blood availed for even him. "I have suffered," he cried, "and come out of the fire scorched and scathed, with the marks upon my person and with the memory of it burnt right into my soul." He likened his life to a snowdrift that had been badly stained. No power on earth could restore its former whiteness and purity. The scars remain. The scars remain, he used to say with bitter self-reproach. Giant yesterday pointed to the black, black past, held it at a threat over the poor penitent's bowed and contrite head, told in tones that sound like thunderclaps that there was no escape. Wounds of the soul, though healed, will ache. The reddening scars remain and make confession. Lost innocence returns no more. We're not what we were before transgression. Jesus is able to save the uttermost. God paints in many colors, but he never paints so gorgeously as when he paints in white. The crimson of the sunset, the azure of the ocean, the green of the valleys, the scarlet of the poppies, the silver of the dewdrops, the gold of the gorse. These are exquisite, so perfectly beautiful, indeed, that we cannot imagine an attractive heaven without them. But in the soul of John B. Gough, we feel that the divine art is at its very best. 44 years have passed away since he had that grim struggle with sin. Gough is again in America, addressing a vast audience of young men in Philadelphia. "Young men," he cries, "perhaps with a bitter memory of those 7 indelible years, young men, keep your records clean." He pauses, a longer pause than usual, and the audience wonder, but he regains his voice. "Young men," he repeats, more feeble this time, "keep your record clean." Another pause. longer than the previous one. But again, he finds the power of speech. Young men, he cries the third time, but in a thin, wavering voice. Young men, keep your record clean. He falls heavily on the platform. Devout men carry him to his burial and make lamentation over him. His race is finished, his voyage complete, his battle won. The promise had been literally and triumphantly fulfilled. The grace that saved him has kept him to the very last inch of the very last yard of the very last mile to the very last minute of the very last hour of the very last day. For he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him in the moment.
To me.